And I'm back with part two of the Daban Avalanche Exia. So I put all the swords on the back, so you can see that. Once again, the mounting points are pretty secure. I'm just going to have to glue the main section on eventually. But we're going to look at the dash parts. Now, let's get the avalanche out of the way. I want to show these first, by themselves. Of course, you get the knee pieces with the added condition points for like you replace the knee armor. Now, in the instructions, they don't actually show you the way I showed it in the first part. They don't show it like that. That is the normal avalanche Exia. But they tell you to put these on. And then that's like avalanche, and then they give you the dash parts, like the leg skis. They tell you to take these off, put the skis on, and then put these on again. But I don't see a reason why. But just like with the shoulders, it's very nicely detailed. Got more yellow than it did before. It's very cool. You do have the double hinge piece, so you can show the thrusters inside. Now, you do have to replace the blue on the knees from the original knee armor on here. But, you know, if you have them like that, it doesn't really matter. So I'll just probably leave them like that for now. And then you have the ski parts. I like the gray here is actually the connection points to the legs. So it gives you some extra detail, but it actually serves a purpose to keep them plugged in. So you got the double hinge connection here. And then you have the part that goes around, like, between the heel and the foot, which is on a little hinge. And then you got, this is really cool, all these parts that are connected here are actually clipped into place. I think the original one, the Dramoka was as well. But this is much more secure feeling. And then this is the same way. Although it does kind of feel like you're going to break it. You can see those little tabs in there, little holes. Little tabs right there, but so far it's holding together really well. And then you have the little claws on the ends of the skis. And there's a hinge to go down with those. Not up, but down. But with this you can easily go up. And then you've got the added panel here that comes down on a double hinge. And you've got extra little claws. Just like with the Dragon Momoko or the Melville. And then you have a hinge here to reveal another thruster. So, yep, it's pretty nice. Like, it's as good, I think, as the Dragon Momoko version, if not a little better in terms of how it solidly connects together. And still it has more detailing, more yellow, extra detail with the white. Yeah, these are blue, I think, on the other one. We'll see it eventually. But I think it's blue. But yeah, these connect very securely together into one solid piece. I don't feel that the claws stay in, like, this is okay, but if they don't feel as secure as the other ones, it's fine. There. And there we go. All down. So let's put it onto the Exia, shall we? Now for that, I'm going to take off the Gian sword. Now I'm going to take this off for now. I'll just make things a little easier. So of course you do have to remove the side panels, which aren't hard to get. You can see that there's the connection points for the legs. It's funny, they come off easily enough, but they don't fall off. It's a nice amount of friction they got. That's really all they're doing, is frictioning around this groove inside here. So, hopefully this will be easy enough. I haven't done it before, because I'm kind of worried I won't get it out. So, we just have to clip that in. There are the grooves made specifically to go in where the gray is. So, it should simply connect together. And it does. Actually, that's really easy. That can be folded up. Yeah, that works well. This is pretty good without the knee pad armor on it. Which I will do after I get the other one on. Where did I put it? Here it is. This should be just as easy. I say that, but you never know how the blue parts do pig in two sections down here, and oh, I think the one's a little loose. Oh, oh, there we go. Perfect. All right. I should go to contend with the back skirt, because it's a lot of stuff now back here. All right, so we got the skis on. Now I just have to remove the knee armor. Which is, like I said, a lot of these parts really do fit securely. There we go. And replace it with the, what was that? Oh. Yeah, they even give you extra little detailing pieces here. Oops. Which do come pegged when you take off the knee armor. Not a huge deal. Yeah, just gotta peg that in. Clicks into place. Looks really good. And there's a little done. And then hopefully this will be as easy to get off. Yeah, it took off the knee pad, or the knee armor. There. And just peg the new armor onto the knee. And there we have it. So that is the Exia Avalanche Dash. All assembled. Looking really good. Let's reconnect this thing. There we go. There we have it. All completed. Looking pretty good. Yeah, this was, like, the detail is amazing. I really do love it. Now I will show the skis down. But first, to make it easier, I might as well show off the base, the stand. Avalanche Exia, no celestial being logos on here. Looks a lot like the middle build one. Pretty much works the same. You got that part, you can swivel up and down. You got this one, you can extend the neck. And then you got this peg here, which will adjust the actual connection point. There we go. Oh no, I wrecked my nail. Ah, poop. So assembling this onto Exia should be quite simple. So we got the little slot in the crutch. Yes. Make your jokes. It's fine. So let's see if I can actually... there's someone... maybe I should have done this before, putting the dash parts on. Whatever. Hopefully I can do this. Let's see, get that right in there. It's a little precarious. I don't know if it'll stay as well as I'd like it to. Ah, poop. Come on, get on there. Alright, well, it's a little jiggly. Not terrible, I don't think it's gonna fall off. So there it is on the stand. Now let's take a look at those skis on the legs. So, you should be able to bring them forward and clip them right in between the foot. So let's see how easily this will work. I see a little line there. I don't know if you can see it. Right there. So I'm thinking it has to go behind that. I would assume. It looks like it. I could be wrong. I don't know. Oh, it seems to be... Okay, I see a groove in there. I guess that's as far as it goes, really. Yeah. So I guess it just goes that far. I think the dry milk went farther. I guess it doesn't really matter. As long as, it, you know, it stays there. But I would kind of like it to be on the actual pad. I guess it works. I guess it's okay. Yeah. All right. I suppose that'll do. So there you have it. Hey, put the foot down, I guess. I didn't think the toe down was better. But yeah, it's not all the way down. So it's not perfect, but it does look pretty good. So let's get the other one down. Yeah, the Dragon Momoko one, it clicked into place, and it's a lot more solid feeling. I mean, it's not going to move because these are stiff joints. But, yep, that is the Avalanche Dash with the skis. And they even call them, they call them sleds? Do they call them skis or sleds? Let me just look at the instruction manual, because it is in English here. But I think it says skis. Let's just see. It's right here somewhere. The sled, yep, they call it the sled. Right there, the sled. So, yep, perfect time for winter, I guess. So that is the Avalanche Dash. And I'm going to, of course, compare to the original. So, I guess I'll get this off the stand first. Or not. There we go. Alright, so let's get these back behind the leg. But yeah, these parts actually, I think, are more secure on this one than the Dragon Momoko, at least on the like the leg connection parts are very, very good for the sled, as they like to call it. Alright, so let's get the camera down. And we can have a good look at a little further down. There we go. So, Daban, Dragon Momoko. Once again, in the first part, you can see they're drastically different. I mean, the colors are different, the design, very different. I've also said, this feels like a combination of the Middle Build and the Master Grade Bandai version together, but this is truly the Middle Build. But I gotta say, I think I this is weird, but I think I like the Daban version a little bit more than the Dragon Momoko. This one's more solid. Dragon Momoko is super stable, solid. This one's not quite there, but just the overall design and appearance of this thing, it's so different. So different. But yeah, you can see these legs are super tight. This ones are a little loose at the hips. Once again, they took cues from the Master Grade Bandai version, which was a bad idea. But yeah, you can see these are blue here, they're white here. You got the yellow on the back here, where the thrusters come out of the legs. See, there's yellow detail here, nothing in here, it's all blue. They got added gray here, where it's just the blue and the white. And like the, actually, yeah, that's blue, that's white there. But the arms, they added yellow, they're bigger. You can see the differences on the legs here. Yeah, these are, it's really cool to have both. I think it's, like, they're both worth having. But then again, this guy is now never going to be made again, so its price is going to be up, 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 up. This one you can get for still a good price. So, I would normally stop here. At least you think I'd stop here. This is where the instructions stop. However, there's going to have to be a part 3. Because Daban, they give you extra pieces. There's extra pieces on there. You've got extra parts on here. And also the Jin Sword Kai blade, which I already took off. We got the leg dome, the domes for the legs, condensers. You got extra parts on this plate, including the battery. This one is the most important, I think, because it has the long rifle for the extra repair 3. There's extra arm parts and back skirt parts here. There's a crap ton of parts here. This is pretty much, not pretty much, it is. This is unused. This is all, I think, for the R3. So yeah, one completely different plate that you don't even touch on the Avalanche. More parts in here. A few parts left here. This is actually where you had the G and sword, but now you can see the Kai parts. And some leg parts. So yeah, as far as I can tell, besides being able to make the Avalanche and Avalanche Dash, you can make the complete normal Exia, Exia Repair 2, and Exia Repair 3. So in the next part, I'm going to cover all three of those, because I'm personally really excited to see how they look with the new design of the Exia. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.